subscribe and hit the bell icon for more notifications.
Unacademy is providing daily T20 free practice tests for both the TS and APMCET. It has started on November 2nd. Week 1 contains biology, zoology, physics, chemistry, mathematics. In week 1, there will be 5 quizzes. In week 2, there will be 5 quizzes. And in week 2, quiz will be on botany, zoology, physics, chemistry and mathematics. And week 4 quiz started on November 23rd and it will end on 29th of November. There will be 4 quizzes. So the quiz will be on botany, zoology, physics and chemistry. Don't forget to enroll for Unacademy and make sure you give this free practice test so that you can analyze your performance and work on its improvement. And there are also upcoming sessions. Links are going to be in the description below. Don't forget to check it out. ESET marks versus rank. Most of the students will be having doubts like, if I get these many marks, how much rank will I get? All these doubts I'm going to clear in this particular video. So if your marks are in between 150 to 160 or above 160, your rank is going to be between 1 to 10. Okay, if your marks are in between 140 to 150, your rank will be in between 10 to 20. Okay, so if your marks are in between 130 to 139, your rank will be in between 21 to 30. If your marks are in between 120 to 130, your rank is going to be in between 31 to 40. And if your marks are in between 110 to 119, your rank is going to be 40 to 50. In between 40 to 50. Like this, you can calculate your rank based on your marks. Okay. Okay. So now let's see how to qualify exam in one day. Okay. First, let's see how to qualify exam in one day. Okay. And now I'm explaining how to qualify exam in one day. Okay, for the students who have not studied anything, who have not started their revision preparation, nothing, for those students this video is. Okay, so after explaining how to qualify exam in one day, I am going to explain last minute preparation tips to get a good score in ESET. Okay, there will be 4 different sections: maths, physics, chemistry and your core. Okay, so there will be questions from 4 different sections. Maths marks will be 50, physics 25, chemistry 25, and 100 marks will be from core. Okay, and we all know the qualifying marks is just 25%. Okay, just to qualify mark is 25%. So the total paper is going to be for 200 marks. We all know that, right? See, out of 200 marks, 25% is 50 marks. So you need to get 50 marks in order to qualify. So now let's see, how can you qualify in just one day? Okay, now our target is to qualify in just one day. So now let's see how. Okay, coming to mathematics, I have already given you the important questions. If you have not seen that video, the link is in the description below. I have given important topics for mathematics, physics as well as chemistry. You need to go through those videos, and if you just prepared those topics, trust me, you're going to get a great score in each of those subjects. Okay, so now let's come back to the video. coming to mathematics, if you follow the important topics which I gave, worst case, you are surely going to get 20 marks. Okay, worst case. If you just read half of the topics which I gave you, you are still going to get 20 marks. Okay, why I am assuring you to take 20 marks as the least case is, first thing is, there is no negative marking. We all know there is no negative marking in the ESET. So out of 50 questions, if you attempt all the 50 questions also, you're still not going to have any negative marking. So you can attempt 50 questions out of 50 questions. In those 50, I'm sure you're going to get at least 20 marks in the worst case. Okay. So now coming to physics. Let's consider you get only 10. Let's consider minimum 10 marks you're going to get. And coming to chemistry, let's think you got only 10 marks. Okay. So here 20 plus 10 plus 10. Already you got 40. And the qualifying marks is just 50. So in core subject, out of 100, minimum you're going to get 30 marks. Minimum. Okay. Because core is something which you have already read. So in core, minimum 30 marks you're going to get. And if you don't know any question, don't leave it. Attempt all the questions because there is no negative marking coming to ESET exam. Remember this technique which I told you, and you can easily qualify ESET exam using. Let's see what are last minute preparation tips. Last minute preparation tips for ESET. Okay. First thing is just analyze how many days are left for exam. For example, if you are left with only 2 days for exam, completely you need to schedule that 2 days. Okay. So that 2 days, prepare a timetable and make sure 60 to 70% of the timetable should consist of your weak subjects and weak topics. Weak topics and weak subjects. Okay. In subjects which you are not confident in the topics which you don't know properly, concentrate on those topics. Okay, this is first preparation tip. Okay, next is you need to prepare short notes. What is short notes? Maintain a small book while reading physics or while reading mathematics or chemistry or in fact any subject. Coming to chemistry, if you read any important equation, or coming to mathematics, if you read any important formula, immediately you need to note that formula in the short notes. Okay. So why I am asking you to maintain a separate short notes is just before the exam also, you can just open that book and go through a quick revision. So coming to mathematics, we already know formula is very, very important. Only when you remember the formula, only you're going to solve the problem. So maintain a short notebook and revise it thoroughly every day. Okay. So whenever you're going to take a small breaks in between your study sessions, just go through those short notes and have a quick revision. Okay. Attempt mock tests. Okay. There will be many mock tests. Just attempt them. And after why I am asking you to attempt mock tests is, once you give mock tests, you will understand what kind of questions are coming, how you are solving the paper, and in which subject you're getting stuck, in which question you're getting stuck, and how is your time management. All these things you can understand only after giving mock tests. Okay, so first give mock tests, and after giving mock tests, make sure you analyze your mistakes and don't repeat those mistakes in final exam. Okay, so next is solve the previous papers. Previous year's papers are really important. You will understand what is the difficulty level of the questions which are appearing in the exam and what kind of questions are asked in the exam. All these things you can understand only by looking previous papers. Okay. So, and next important tip is don't start new topics. Don't start new topics. See guys, you already know if you are left only with few days of your exam, don't start any new topic. If you start any new topic, you'll be confused what you read already. Those topics also you're going to forget. So that's why don't start any new topic. And next is concentrate on high weightage topics, high weightage and important topics. Whatever topics I gave you as important or a high weightage, concentrate on those topics, okay, in order to get a very good score in your exams. Next important thing is time management. Manage your time wisely. Time management is really important because you have a limited time and so many questions. So don't waste your time. Before going to exam only, fix your mind how much time you're going to give for single question. After that time, just automatically go for next question. Don't waste your time just by getting stuck with single question, okay? Next important thing is before your exam on exam day only, make sure you put all your required things at a place so that on exam day there you need not panic searching for the documents, admit card and all. So now
yeah, that's it for today. Hope you found this video useful. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video with all your friends. Thanks for watching.